Hello there, by the channel that brought you Do Birds Pee? I now present to you, Do Fish Have Tongues? My background is a little bit different. I am visiting my home country of Bulgaria for the next couple weeks. Although I've lived in Canada for most of my life, I am back here for a couple weeks and I've been visiting museums, going to the beach, so you'll get some cool science content from me over the next few weeks from a different continent. You'll also have to excuse the lighting. It is very hot here, so we're trying to pull down the shades to avoid overheating. Unfortunately, that makes the video a little dark. We're gonna deal. On to the topic du jour, do fish have tongues? Let's start off simple. What is a tongue? In most vertebrates, it's a muscular organ at the bottom of our mouth that helps us move food around. The tongue helps us with chewing, breaking down food, and swallowing. Our tongue also hosts the majority of our taste buds, allowing us to taste sweet, savory, sour, bitter, and salty. So, do fish have tongues? Many fish have a bony structure in their mouth called the basophil, which looks a lot like a tongue and lies at the bottom of the mouth. This structure has a very low range of motion and doesn't have many muscles. It also lacks any taste buds. So it's not very muscular, it doesn't have any taste buds. The only thing it does have in common with the human tongue is its location, at the bottom of the mouth. The basophil is thought to have evolved as a barrier for the ventral aorta of the fish, which is an artery at the bottom of the fish's mouth. The basophil helps protect the ventral aorta from damage, such as due to squirming prey. We can hardly call this a tongue since it has none of the features or functions of one. It's just a protective barrier in the same location as most vertebrate tongues. So most fish don't have a functional tongue. Why? Turns out they don't need one. Underwater, fish just suck water containing food into their mouth and to the back of their throats where they can swallow. Remember that life began in water. So fish developed this feeding mechanism before any creature ever walked on land. And here's the cool part. As fish evolved to walk on land, they had to evolve to eat on land too. When you're surrounded by air, this sucking mechanism that most fish use underwater does not work. Air alone can't push water to the back of your throat and allow you to swallow. Instead, land-dwelling vertebrates evolved a tongue that catches food and moves it to the back of the throat to let them have a delicious meal. So fish don't need tongues because they have water. It's just a land animal thing. What? Scientists studied modern day amphibians called mudskippers to get an idea of how fish evolved to eat on land. These critters climb onto land with their mouths filled with water. Using x-ray cameras and high-speed video cameras, these scientists watch mudskippers suck food into their mouth along with the water already inside and use the flow of the water to help them swallow their food. In this case, the water's acting like a hydroponic tongue, pushing food to the back of the throat to allow for eating. Scientists believe this is how the first land animals ate, until they evolved fleshy tongues, which let them be even more independent on land. Wild. What? That's it for today's video. Thank you for enduring this strange lighting situation. I hope you learned something new. I know I did while researching this video. Be sure to hit that subscribe button to join our science community. And remember that science is everywhere.